Can you hear me? Let's see. Vingador, yeah. The sound is a bit low. You mean the music or? Sorry, the game is starting. No one is getting close. Fuck close. Alright, I'll try to put them up a bit. I don't even know what they're playing. Why is Ringador on the fucking tripod? Sorry, does it work now? Let me fix it a bit more. Should be better now. No one wants to arrest me. He got the proc from Druid, by the way, so that's why he was surviving. Look at this guy, by the way, on my team. I don't really know what my team is doing though. And now they're trebbing instead. He missed his spike. Oops. Really kept. What? I can't port? No, no. My port or my return didn't work for some reason. Since they're surging with, or the thief is just chasing me, like he doesn't care about anything else, then we can just snowball the rest of the map instead. If Wingdor actually did any damage. So you should engage on the druid. Low rev, do you? He's not doing any damage, like, what are you doing? Like, the guy is fucking dead, you know? Lol. Like, holy shit, what the fuck are you doing? We got the druid. we trigger Bassi here. Ah, I got it. Plague stomp, boys. He doesn't have steel up, so it's okay. Thief missed his steal. All he does is try to go for me, by the way, the whole game. That was first game in like 2 weeks or something. Or 1.5 week. No, I'm not gonna go bald. Is it normal that I cannot pick on decent Condi Mesmers? I mean, you should not die from them if that's what you're saying. Oh. Like, you should have enough cleanse for that. But I mean, you should not take up pure 1 versus 1, if that's what you mean, against them. By the way, is the sound better now? Let's go some right. Yeah, it's because they run pretty tanky, like that's why I can get away with running Executioner. Like, sure, the Condi might be a little bit annoying, but yeah, it should be fine. Nissi and Prince Vingador lose, boys. Even better that I went Executioner because he went Scrapper instead of Necro. So it's even better that I went Executioner. Like, they had some, like, the Condi pressure could have been a little bit too much because of Necro and Mesmer, but now that he went Scrapper, it's absolutely fine. The only awkward thing is, like, I guess I'm gonna cap close then because he's not even back yet. But Vingador is gonna get, like, shit on in the start. Okay, so one guy is even coming here. So we triggered a passive trap. Oh, there are two here. Then we disengage. But Vingador is already dead because he's garbage. They should get the rest, it's an Ellie. I guess not. Oh, they actually got the rest, yeah, that's fine. So we decap, and then we rotate back into middle. And we kill the Ellie here. It's easy because he doesn't have any stab, so we just headshot him. And we can actually maybe try and... Then we decap them. They could have gotten the rest, I think. I'm actually gonna get the rest. Nope. What? Oh, he got ported up. Lol. Because Vingador is running that retarded thing. But why is our Mesmer just sitting on fucking middle? This game will be legit impossible to fucking carry because retarded people. I don't know what they're doing. And are... No! How can they leave? What are you doing? Like, they leave one fight to go to another one? How did I not get this? Oh my god. Nope. I won't get the stomp off. They're all dying like completely stupid. Like, look, this is what we are losing to, you know? We got the wings. He should be dead here. We should still be able to win this. Like, I'm not saying it's gonna be easy, but so Ellie's gonna come for the res, I guess. I sincerely hope he gets the stomp, like he should not have any problem. Yeah, he got the stomp. Then we get the full cap here. Is he going for the druid? Okay. I hate that proc though, it's a bit annoying actually. Oh, he got the... And Vingador dead, of course. Like, what are you doing, dude? Oh my god, the timing. Now I'm gonna die. Nope. Like, how can you die against an Ellie off point? Like, Vingador, what are you doing? Warrior just runs past the scrapper, I guess. So Vingador is already dead. The druid should go down bottom, by the way. So we start up, we get some stacks as well. He corrupted him and now we spike. We can actually, yeah, we go close. Vingador has probably the most games of everyone in this game and he's still just bad. He's dead. So we did get the scrapper. What? I get annoyed because it's bugging so much. Okay, he was already dead, I guess. Here we just do one spike, so we ease the pressure from the for the mesmer, or we could actually maybe finish him. No, okay, because I want the upper buff. How do you like warriors? I don't know, I don't really mind warriors at the moment. I was a little bit too late with the... We bested the Mesmer here. We're gonna juke him, by the way. Okay, never mind. We won. Does Bassi work on Mesmer clones? Yes, it does. And especially like if they attack or whatever, they will also pro... Yeah. So, but you can only share up to 5 targets, so... I'm getting insta-pops, that's pretty sick. Yeah, I don't really play warrior, so asking like if you're asking me warrior questions, I can't really give you any good answers. Why don't you go back to your Silvari look? This is my Silvari. Everyone copies the look, so I don't like it. Look what I made today, by the way. Staff thief. Maybe one day. Oh, I swapped to X. No, yeah. Good. Oh, I'm so tired. I don't even know why I streamed. I got, like, I wasn't supposed to stream today. I just got inspired by Rom when he streamed, so I felt like, sure, why not? And I actually have a... I have moved, so I haven't tried the new internet at all, so I don't know. It feels a little bit laggy, but... Like, I usually have 30 ping, now I have like 55. It shouldn't matter that much, but... He popped everything instantly, by the way. Here we steal. Interrupt. We stealth him. We can actually decap middle, I think. Nah, never mind. We go for the rev here. Even if it's retry, I think he used heal already, right? And yeah, no, I'm gonna actually kill everything. Then we decap. Like, we're not gonna get the full cap anyways. so it's more value getting this. Like, sure, they can keep getting the kills and stuff, but... And here, I just want to go for the kill again. We stomp. And then we plus one on close. Never mind, we don't, because it's two. And then we go far. You can just hunt respawns. Like, I'm fine with the 2v2 on close, because they should not really die, but like, there are two guardians. They should have enough cleanse and... Okay, never mind, it actually died. So we stun him first. He's gonna staff 5. We bait the staff 5. Even better, because he swapped out of Glint. We might kill him before he... Nope. Oh, what? I got procced by the trap. That's rip. I got pretty high burst from it. Fire K and lightning, I guess. I cannot really help them on middle, because they are dead more or less. What? Oh, I feel laggy now. We plus one. Like, I don't really want to stay middle, even though I could theoretically, but this guy already used I don't want to go close, because he's dazing most likely. He's dead. Why is he leaving? Oh, he's going for boss. I don't even know why he went for boss there. So we stomp here. No, he got staff 5, I think. Oh, wow. We might get the decap though. With Bassi here, he gets procced, and we can fear. He should be forced into Shroud soon, yeah. And we can actually kill him. And if the respawn don't come here, we will go for the Necro. So we stomp him. I mean, we can full cap here and force him to come back. And there's actually one guy coming here now. But I'll get the full cap before. And then we go from... We can... No, why are you coming here? Middle is like open and he pushes far instead into two respawns. Like, that's not a good play. Instead, he could have gone middle and capped. And I could have gone close and helped. Now they get reinforcement to close and we will die on close actually. But I guess he gets the 1v1 on far. They're actually winning close for some reason, even though they are outnumbered. But for me to go there, it's no point. Like, this is the best. Oh, I actually got decapped in middle. Oh, that's fine though. We can try to save the Guardian, actually. Wow. This one trap wonders. I didn't get the interrupt on the heal. That's a bit annoying, actually. And we Bassy here. We got the decap, though. That's okay. Oh my god. I'm dead. Just pop all your traps, dude. Oh my god, this is so fucking funny. We still top full, because they're probably gonna go boss right. Yeah. I have no idea if I'll be able to steal it. We get the decap too. What? How could I not jump? Sorry, dodge. Could just go for boss, but that's boring. Why did you make the staff? I don't know, man. Maybe I'll use it sometime. But I mean, I play Rev sometimes, I guess. And Mesmer. So... But yeah, I don't mind Guardians actually. Like, the only thing is sometimes I don't expect people to be like play full traps, you know, and I put traps on a point. Like, I don't expect people to be that dumb, you know. It's such a retarded build anyways. But yeah, that's why I find it, like, that's the only part I hate, when I don't think about people might have put full traps on a point that they don't even guard, you know. I did some games this season where I tried to go decap on far, and then suddenly I walk into full traps when I'm low already. I disengage middle just to go far, and I don't get the reset in HP in time, and then I just die by all the traps. I'm like, what the fuck? That shit is stupid. What's your favorite class after Thief? I'd say Mesmer, but I don't enjoy the Condi build. I guess a little bit, but I used to enjoy Power Shatter a lot. I actually had an idea. I got the inspiration from a guy who made a roaming video. I think he's American as well. And like, sometimes, you know, I've been whining a lot about cleave, right? Like, when you go in with dagger cleave, you just die, and it feels sometimes you don't have enough cleave. So the idea was, on some maps, like maybe Legacy and maybe Forest to some extent, but definitely not Kylo or Temple, I could see you swap a short bow out for staff, and just, but I wouldn't go bound or something like that. Like, I've seen some thieves play bound with this, but that makes you so slow around the map. Like, but I could legit see staff for the down cleave instead of short bow, and then you would vault the bodies, then you won't take as much cleave, and I don't know. I kind of like the idea, but I haven't really tried it out. I don't like this ping though. Feels like I have slight delay from what I used to have. Try it now then. You guys ask me why I have so many legendaries. Have you not seen Nos, how much gems he has? Like, has no one of you ever seen Noscock stream when he showed like 23k gems or something? Thanks, man, still for the gold. But yeah, a lot of gold I got back in the days when we played ESLs, like when it wasn't any cash. Then back then it was more gems that you won, like 2k gems per every Thursday. And then Gophers were also, like, second place was always gems. Nos buys gems, confirmed. No, I think he just legit saved every, like, he stacked up on all those. Surprised you're streaming. Yeah, I'm pretty surprised myself. ₹83k gems, yeah, that's what I mean. I mean, ₹3k5, yeah, but I borrowed some money from a friend, that's why I... So you guys should send me gold. But yeah, I usually don't stream Monday to Friday. Like, Friday is like the only exception. But usually I'm so tired under the weekdays. Like today, I'm like a zombie and I'm still streaming. I feel like I'm playing so sloppy and bad. Like, first game was a catastrophe. But the thing is, I saw Rom streaming And then I got like inspired to stream. Like, I haven't streamed in a week or 1.5 weeks. At least people are not grinding this shit so much as last season. Like, look at this. This is all I actually bothered with, and look at this. This is fucking insane. Like, do you understand how many games you have to play to get this? Yeah, and I felt like 5 was a lot. Does Team PZ have a thief? I have no idea. The armor skin I use is an outfit. But if you want to look at the armor I use on like without the outfit. Well, hopefully next season they will give us incentive to go for legendary tiers rather than the nothingness we're receiving, almost nothing. I don't know, man, like they've been talking a lot about rewards and maybe making it more prestigious. I mean, we will have to see, but yeah, I don't know if it's gonna be next season or if it's gonna be in the future. Is blinding powder better than bandit defense? This question, I swear, I love it. I'll get back to you in a sec. Is thief slash daredevil a flexible class? I mean, it depends on what you like. You can play a little bit of everything, but the role is kind of the same, if that's what you're asking. Blinding powder versus bandit's defense, like I've said it many times, like the only play I see for bandit's defense is if you feel like you're getting stunned a lot when you play, like when you do games and you feel you're getting CC'd and you die by the CC, then I'd suggest you drop blinding powder for bandit's defense. Since it's a shorter stun break than Shadow Step. But that's the only reason, like, that's the only play you have for Bandit Stevens. Like, it's a stun break. Like, the block itself is kind of bad. I don't know. I don't like it. You have so many dodges. Like, you should be able to dodge the damage itself. But meanwhile, Blinding Powder has so many plays. Like, you can use it offensively, you can use it defensively, you can use it as support. I mean, it's so many things you can use it for. It's not just one thing. It doesn't have like one specific thing you do, you know? You can interrupt stomps. Like if your teammate is getting stomped, you can stealth him. You can stealth low teammates. So if they have Kondi Warrior, what do you mean, like that you, but Bandit's defense wouldn't make any difference, you mean, unless you die by the CC, if that's what you mean, more or less. No, it's fine, like I don't mind asking, getting the questions, like, about Banished Defense versus Blinding Powder. And as I said, like, this is my own preference, and I'm not saying it's wrong to run Banished Defense by any means. Like, it's, if you feel like, as I said, if you feel that you're dying by the CC, like if you get CC'd a lot in games and you die by it, then you should definitely run it, you know. It will save you more than Blinding Powder in that case. But for me, Blinding Powder, I can use it offensively. I can use it, you know, sometimes you damage something and then you do a quick Blinding Powder backstab on a target that is slow, that won't expect the burst, instead of you having to 5-2 and then backstab, you know. Or you can even, like, you see a low target, you Blinding Powder and steal, you know, instead of doing 5-2. So it's, there's tons of things that you can do compared to what you can do. And then obviously it's easier decaps, because you can, like, instead of being so predictable with stealthing up in a team fight like this, then people will start seeing that, oh, he might go for a decap, we start backing off, you know, from the fight. Meanwhile, if you just blind, you start dodging and you Blinding Powder, you can even Black Powder and Blinding Powder, so you get maximum stealth, you know. You can stealth low teammates, like Shadow Step, Blinding Powder, a teammate that is low on 2-3% HP, and he can re-sustain and survive. Like, those plays you cannot make with Bandit's Defense, so it kind of only has one role, or whatever you want to call it. Improv or Executioner, that's also, like, depending on matchup. Against this setup, for example, I prefer Executioner, because they're so tanky, right? If it was a Thief, or let's say even a, I kind of want him to attack first, so they proc the, they have this weakness thing, right? Oh, I can't reach him anymore. Feels like they're being silly. We decapped. Have they got a kill, actually? We can force the portal from Mesmer, and he put it on an awkward spot. Oh, he actually even timed out. That's perfect. We can go for a full cap here, then. Build diversity that Thief can't do support. I mean, I've seen some ninja, whatever, kind of weird builds people run in World vs. World, if that's what you mean, like support, ninja nurse or whatever they call it. Like, but if you mean like pure support, yeah, of course not. Like, you're not gonna have a Mesmer or something like that, yeah. Oh, sorry, like a Druid or Ellie. He should give me a target to middle. He hasn't pressured him at all. And they can't kill the Guardian on close. This match seems to be really bad. Like, they're wasting so much time with bunker classes, not being able to kill stuff, so that makes it awkward. But we should be able to snowball here. Okay, so we got two kills here, right? And there are three people in middle, so we can get decap on far. The Guardian is already leaving, though, but we might... Oh, they're actually a pre-made. Are they actually a full team? I think so. No, four people. Interesting. We take the quickness from the mess. He should be dead. We gotta cleave hard, though. This is what I meant with, like, imagine if you had staff there. Instead, you wouldn't take that much cleave, maybe. So we disengage middle. Like they should be fine this like. So we juke back because the druid came. I did not expect him to really go there, but he swapped to staff. We should be able to kill him here, actually. Maybe. I keep forgetting that I'm executioner. And the rest power is so stupid. I don't know. It's really hard because they're probably on team speak and stuff, so they can call out everything. You know, be a lot more coordinated and stuff. And this is bad. Like, you should never outnumber with a warrior and a mesmer. Like, that fight does not make sense at all. And our Rev just leaves randomly to plus one, even more. Like, what are they doing? This is even worse. Like, these rotations are completely awful. And he's going for boss now. Please. I really can't stand things like this. Like, they're... And warriors is camping close. You can't play with this. Like, you cannot win a game when people do this. Vibassi here. I'm getting chain CC, what the fuck? We should kill the druid here. But there's no way we're getting the stomp here. Nope. But there are three people here, so we should be able to disengage to middle. Warrior already losing close. And this Rev, he did sword 3 with confusion up. That's why he took so much damage. It's not good at all to do that, by the way. Wow, that dodge. We got the interrupt, he should be dead here. This game is not gonna be winnable though. Shall we leave to middle? We dazed the gyro. What is the Rev doing? Rev? Oh my god, is he going for the rest instead? Oh, Jesus Christ. This game is lost. He's gonna die though. He's gonna stun me. Fuck, I didn't get it. So here we stun him with just headshot him, Bassi, and then. I'm gonna die by the burn, maybe. And he got Aegis proc. Yep, this game is over. Like, it's impossible to win with these people. Like they're losing everywhere. They're just sitting on each node. We got the heal, he should be dead. I mean, I don't think it's gonna be enough. Even if we wipe them here, I legit don't think it's gonna be enough. Because we kind of need both bosses and probably more. I'm stuck, I'm probably gonna die by his cleave. We got the heal. Oh, he didn't die. I don't think, like, we would need a decap, but I don't think that's enough either. Maybe if they throw it, you know, why are they being so greedy? We're getting the decap, maybe. Lol. Hello? We get the rest here. No, I can't. I have to be in node, but I cannot. I need to. Yeah, I'm probably gonna die now. Nope. We can actually maybe win this. Are you kidding me? He's going for boss, most likely. Like, it doesn't matter if the decap close. If we kill them now. Get the stone, come on. Nope. Fuck. Now they're losing middle right. I interrupted the trap, but everything else is decapped. I don't think we can. I don't think it's enough. Yeah, they're dying in middle now. Yeah, I can't. And they're dying everywhere, so. They even got the boss. Is this ranked? Yeah, this is ranked, yeah. That's how confusion used to be. Like, confusion used to be only when you activate any skill, that's when you take damage. Then they swap to so it also makes that so you split the skill now, so you take damage and Thief supposed to win 1v1 with Rev, right? Or all the revs? I mean, you should beat Invo revs, yes. Retri rev obviously is not something you kill easily or quick. But if it's a pure 1v1, then yeah, sure, you can win. They should nerf function gyro. Yeah, I said it many times. Like, I dislike the whole idea of having something. Like, a person should not be able to get a second kind of thing to rest as quickly as a normal player. Like, one person should not be able to rest as two people. That's what I dislike. So, anything like gyro and druid pets, even if it's different cooldowns and stuff and it's not even as powerful, I still dislike the idea. Just tone both down to like 60 or 75 seconds internally and then make it to only 50% rest power instead of something ridiculous like 100%. That's just silly. Yeah, they change confusion, how it works, more or less. Yes, but they tone down the damage on skill. Yeah, I haven't really read the forums about that, but I really hope, like, it's not as stupid as season 1 with mesmers, like bunker mesmer and infused light back in the day, but it's still really silly that you can more or less like out-res people with like with one player against like three players. That's just insane, at least according to my point of view, you know, like. And especially since Thief already struggle on cleaving, since you're so squishy, like, isn't there actually a patch tonight? I'm unsure. I saw that they're releasing some kind of new map, the 20th, and also a new PvP map, but I haven't seen it or read anything about it, but I asked someone in the guild wrote that they're gonna release a new map. I'll probably stick with execution against this setup as well. Yeah, I mean, you don't completely have to remove the whole idea of having like gyro rest and pet rest and stuff. Just tone it down. Like, don't have it rest as quickly as another player. That's just ridiculous, you know. At least put it down to 50%. If it's too little, then put it up to 60-70%, you know. Keep finding that balance, like that little, like, here's the perfect number, you know, but don't have it to be 100%, because that's just legit stupid. Noctil will probably be, I don't know. I wasn't planning on streaming that long. Hey Tengu, by the way. Grey Cut, yeah, exactly, completely new map. Seen you playing World of Warcraft? No, I'm not. Honestly, I want them just removed altogether in PvP. Maybe, yeah. I don't know. I can live with it, but tone it down a lot. Like, they wanted a faster gameplay, right? So they removed clerics and stuff, so... Yeah. Meanwhile, you can rest people now forever and ever and ever. Let's see if he reacts. Oh fuck, I shouldn't have headshotted him there. We baited everything now. Oh, he dazed me. It's okay, now he used... So now we stealth. Ah, oh, I didn't get the good hit either. We clear. He doesn't have shield block. Oh yeah, he did. Never mind. I mean, this is not optimal at all either, but... What the fuck was that burst? Can he rest me? That was bad. I don't know what killed me that quickly, but... It's okay, they're like overcommitting like fuck anyways, so... bad. No, I didn't get the heal either. He's like the druid is not doing anything, by the way. Oh, did I swap back to executioner or am I... We busted him here. Oh my god. We mobilize him here. We should win this game still. Maybe not. Just kidding. Rest through everything. How am I not even hitting that? He did not. I'm gonna die probably. What? Oh, the fucking pet? Lol. They're getting the rest, by the way. Oh my god, what is my team doing? Did he not see me? Are you kidding me? Oh my god, what are they doing? I give up. Like, what are they doing? Like, honestly. Oh my god. Did I swap to execution? Yeah, I am. Maybe I should have stayed impro against this anyways. They're just dying all over the map, like... This necro is 1v2ing them, by the way. Hype. I hope that they're pushing like somewhere else. So we get this. Why is he coming close? Like, okay, this game is not gonna be able, we're not gonna be able to win. So we get the druid here. Can they stomp, please? I honestly don't know what they're doing. So far should be open, and I hope the druid. I don't know what he's doing. Feels like we are so far behind, but maybe we can still win. Can we even win with one? Probably someone is gonna go close soon. No one is capping middle. We got the heal, he should be dead here. If Necro is going close, we kill him. He is. I don't know, this seems like it's gonna be really hard to come back from, but... I don't wanna get transferred here. That would oh, they have three people here. Then we gotta leave here. Like, I can't... So Scrapper is 1 versus 3, we win middle, we win far. We need to win far before they get the respawn. We killed the continuum split. No, apparently not. He tried to Moa, interrupt again. So we stomp. We don't want to get let him get the rest. Or we can actually bleed him now. Let him use cooldowns just to try and rest, okay? They're still dying, like, in spawn, like... And now they get decapped in middle for no reason. Even full capped. And they're not still winning. They're losing close even though they're outnumbering. Or have been outnumbering. Or should have been. Okay, then this game is lost. Why is Warrior? Yeah, Warrior, you should push middle. But I don't think we can win with 2 cap only. I don't think it's gonna be enough. We interrupted the rest. Not gonna get the rest, because they're dead everywhere else. Then the game is over. And the druid is absolutely useless, just sitting on far, like, not doing anything. Again, like, why are you outnumbering with the necro? Sorry, scrapper. That's GG. Something I hate is when stuff gets obstructed. That's the only thing I want to get fixed. I don't know, it happens rarely, but when it happens, like if you get like steel obstructed, that shit is stupid as fuck. Like you get the port, you get the cooldown, but you don't land the steel. It's hard for me because I only play in action cam. Hey Yoster, by the way. I made Nevermore, should I give it to my Mesmer Druid? Dude, I don't know. Like, you can just skin it on whatever. If we get Legacy, let's go staff instead of short bow. Let's see if it works, boys. Yeah, I'm just swapping out the short bow in that case. I just want to see if the cleave is really that good. What's this ore mumbo jumbo? What do you mean? Oh, I wasn't saying that I would play staff only, like I would swap like this. This is how I would go. So I play normal DP and when something goes down we cleave with staff. Like I'm not gonna go bound and stuff, like I'm just gonna play normal build. I mean if you really 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 want, I could go a normal staff build I guess with bound and I don't really know how to play it but. I don't even know how you're supposed to play it. Should we play it like team fight or whatever? Stuff. Yeah, I had someone tell me about the donations. I don't know. I tried to change it to a Tippy stream or whatever it's called. Nokt told me to do that, but I don't seem to get it to work at all. Like I suck at this so hard, so I need some help after, maybe through the weekend to get it to work, because I'm obviously not getting it to work. Yeah, but I did put it up, but for some reason it's not working. Like I have the link and everything. Oh, never mind. It wasn't even what? No, it should be fine. Like I tried it before on the test thingy, but I didn't get it to work. What targeting? Control T to target and Control V, like Control V, yeah, V to take the target. Like I remember on Tippy stream, like I put up everything, but for some reason it's just not working. I think that if you program a schedule once a week, stream evening for instance, and that you set up TP stream, that could work really well. So, should we? No, I don't really want to staff in this map, to be honest. Yeah, I don't think I'll ever be able to get a schedule. Like, if I say that I'm gonna stream under the week, then one day I get off work and then I'm just gonna be super tired and I'm not gonna feel like streaming. And I'm such a kind of mood person as well. Like, if I don't feel like streaming, then I won't stream, even if I said I will stream. So yeah. Okay, then let's go. How do we do this? If it sucks, I'll swap. Like these guys are arguing, like this guardian. Never mind, he swapped. This guy think he's some kind of fucking god. I don't wanna cap close though. No one wants to cap close. What? No, this doesn't work. I can't play with this. I don't know how to dodge with staff. Let's go DP instead. I can die to a pleb thief with staff, then I can't. I don't even have daggers! Can I? I can't. What? I can't equip on this one. Fuck. Oh my god. Yeah, right. No, I'm staff on this one! Okay, then I gotta go rev, boys. Oh my god. Easy game, boys. Thief is gonna spike. No, I can't. I got the stealth, that's perfect. Cleave the thief. Why did he port to us? I'm gonna die probably. Yep. How did they really get the rest of? Oh my god, he's playing some fucking Hambo shit. No wonder. The song, it's called. Let me write it down. Give me a sec and I'll give it, okay. I don't know, I don't think I'm retro on this one. No, I'm not. They got upper buff too. I think I've never seen like a Hambo in a long time. they keep leaving fights, and the Mesmer, I don't know what the Mesmer is doing, honestly. Yeah, Greatsword Hammer, that's like the new build. I should have never gone staff. Honestly, I don't think it would have made a difference. I don't think we can win anyways. I can't even get the target up. Baited boy. What? He got... Oh my god. He's gonna get stomped now. I keep forgetting that he has the unblockable thing. Should get a small window. Yeah, maybe. The Mesmerist keeps dying anyway, so it's... I don't think you like. Oh, I don't think getting bottom buff with upper buff would even like we won't be able to hold any of this. Oh, let's swap back to DP though. That Mesmer was useless, and he was riding in team chat the whole game, like look. Let's see, they started the whole game, they were writing to each other like retards. No staff, no win. Yo, I couldn't even get back to DP for some reason because I had no thief with DP. I think that game would have been easy with DP, maybe. I'm not sure, but... That Mesmer thinks he was like some fucking god, you know? You need to reload to highlight that. Maybe, man, maybe. That was pretty funny, though. Percent of PvP community think they're gods. There's plenty of things, Greycut. I mean, you can also have people like guild chat or stuff. I mean, it's one thing if you say that you're good and stuff, but and you can back it up, you know. But these guys that do it, you have never seen them ever in PvP, like maybe in Hot Join or some shit. But no pro league, not even a challenger team, not even any Gold Force, no ESLs. You know, it's like they don't even know what PvP is yet. You know. Does a good Revenant have a chance versus a good Thief? If you play Retrirev and versus a Thief, and like if both are equally as good, I think the matchup is really skill based, in my opinion. Like I think it can go both ways, to be honest. I don't know. At least that's how I feel. I haven't really dueled that many really, really, really good Revenants, but I mean, Invocation, you should hands down beat as Thief. Like, you should just delete them from the game because they can't do anything about the interrupts, because you should be able to like interrupt everything. But Retrirev just becomes so tanky, you know, and you kind of have to play slow against them with DP, and you can't really interrupt them because they have perma stab if they cover it really good, you know. Like, the only time where you can get since the stab on dodge has a internal cooldown on like 5 seconds, so if they dodge and you steal straight after, then they have like a short window where they can't get any stab, so that's when you can headshot them. But even so, like, it's so hard to get headshots off. You can't interrupt anything, more or less. So it's more like you got a kite, and once they get the dwarf proc on 50% HP, you kind of have to reset as well, because yeah, it just takes a long time. Frey said that Draze farms his Rev on Thief even if he's retry. Yeah, I mean, as I said, like, if it's just a pure straight up one versus one on a node, whatever, like, even so, I still think a Rev can reset, you know. You're like, if you only think, like, if you want to 1v1 on beach and only take it as a pure 1v1, sure, then Thief can probably win most matchups. But if you take into account, like, map node, you can kind of point, you know, it's so dangerous for a Thief to, like, if the Rev starts jumping up, you know, to stuff and kite to spots where you can't steal. Like, if you don't care about node, then the Rev can just resustain and resustain and resustain, you know. Reset cooldowns and you're back to square one, more or less. But it's... The Rev duel is kind of more just to bait out their stuff, you know, the dodges. And the only time, like, where you can get killed is by the taunt. Like, if you don't have any cleanse for the taunt or shadow step or stun break or whatever. Death Knight. Ellie is decent now, but struggled a bit in game. No, Ellie's still fine. Like, the thing is, it's hard in solo queue because you don't really have much team support like peels. But in a team environment where you play like 5v5, like let's say competitive or whatever, Ellie's still fine and viable because then you get peels. Like, I'd say still Ellie is one of the best team fighter supporters in the game. Like, it still beats Druid hands down. Like healing wise, we're talking about, obviously. So even with Menders, it's fine as long as you have peels. Obviously, it's not gonna be as good as clerics, but it still works, you know. Doesn't Druid heal better? No, Ellie heals much better. Also, it offers more support, as in like auras and stuff. Ellie has much more, like, I don't know, I feel like they have much more impact in a team fight than a Druid has. Yeah, I mean, if you're talking about like queuing and stuff, obviously it doesn't feel competitive at all. I can agree with that to 100%. The only time where we actually like feel that we care more about the games is more like when it's pro league and stuff like that, you know. That's when it's competitive, you know. But I agree, like, you don't have the feeling that, like, in Dota for example, when you climb up to like 9k MMR, the games feel like super intense, you know. You really you care about them, you want to play your best and etc, you know. People actually have a goal to farm for. Meanwhile in Guild Wars 2, it's like legendary isn't even skill based, you know. You just queue and people will eventually get legendary. So can you explain mechanics behind your fast movement? What do you mean, like movement around the map, or do you mean like the usage of the skills, or? I mean, something I really miss is the weeklies, like the ESL weeklies. Everyone stopped playing them, you know, as soon as they put gem prizes only for if it was max 8 teams or stuff. And to be honest, people don't really care about gems anymore as they used to. But everyone remembered how hype, like, then back with Go4 and ESL weeklies, you had like two tournaments like very very often that people would enjoy watching, you know. Now it's like, yeah, you wait for Pro League, it's like 2-3 months or whatever, even more maybe, until, you know, the next Pro League, and it lasts for 7 weeks, and then that is like one game, every team plays one game once a week, you know. It's not as often. It would also open up for more teams to be seen, you know, and get practice, of course, like new teams that want to become good. Now it's like no possibility, like all the top teams scrim each other. Meanwhile, all the new teams have no way to actually get into the scene. They have to scrim other teams that, like, they can never measure themselves against the better teams and see, like, oh, we get absolutely crushed against a Pro League team, you know. And it's kind of sad that it is like that, to be honest. And GoForce and like ESL weeklies would have changed that, because then you can actually queue up but you could have played every week against the top teams, and then that's that, you know? I mean, obviously, that would have been better for the other teams, but... You mean like a TV kind of thing? Which is a better 1v1, Druid or Mesmer? To be honest, both are really strong in 1v1s, but I'd say Druid has the most matchups. Mesmer is more like all in, like a class with everything, you know, you're kind of, you're a strong 1v1 player, like if you're strong in 1v1, and then it's also more like, it can also be like a playmaker kind of role. Not even 1 to 2 months to get legendary, like legit, if you want to, like people got it after 1 week you know, but and it's not like, you know, getting 9k MMR in Dota, that's like the top, what, 0.1% of the fucking game, and in here legendary, like legit every player has it, you know, it's not even an achievement. Yeah, it kind of has become like that in many games. I don't know, maybe not in World of Warcraft. I'm actually unsure, but I agree with you that people in Guild Wars feels so spoiled in many ways that they feel that they deserve all the rewards or all the cosmetics that are in the game. Like if it exists, you should be able to obtain it. You know, kind of the same in PvE, you know, it's no, or even legendaries, you know, it's like, it's only time that it requires. It doesn't require you to be good in PvE or like top guild in PvE. But you wonder about how are you, why, or like using my utilities fast? I don't really get the question. Kligor, or yeah. I'm not getting Q-pop now for some reason. Is this elitist talk 101? Not really. I'm just comparing how some MMOs used to be. I mean, I like the system World of Warcraft has, like with the gladiator titles and stuff. Like it doesn't necessarily have to be any cosmetics. Like titles are still also like a carrot, whatever that is more unique for some players, that can only be obtained by, you know, top players. Even in PvE, like I'd love to see it, you know. Like in World of Warcraft, you have to more or less be top 0.5% in your battleground or battle group, whatever. It's like a battle group consists of X amount of servers, like let's say 18 servers, and I don't know how many players that is, but basically 0.5% only get Gladiator, and that title only lasts per season. Like if you don't get Gladiator next season, you get like a special mount that changes like depending on the season, like it has different looks. But I don't like the fact that you have no carrot here to like there's no incentive to get legend right now in Guild Wars. And there's no incentive to be the best PvE guild. Like you don't really get anything special or what do you think about Superior Rune of the Mesmer on DP Daredevil? I don't like it. I don't know what happened to the queue. I still miss my vengeful gladiator title. I actually had Furious Gladiator. If you could have anything, what would you want for being the top team in a season? Like, I don't know. I don't have any opinion what I would want myself, but something that is more unique, like any skin whatsoever, like something that is nice that I always wanted that I don't know if you can even obtain it anymore. Like, I used to use them a lot. The Glorious Armor, I think. Yeah, Glorious Armor. So these have like an upgraded version. Like some players got it from Tournament of Glory, it was called. It's like ages ago. So if you want that, you got full set. Also, there was a period when they had the old leaderboards that when you were top 10 or top 5 or something like that, you would be able to get one piece or two pieces depending on your placement. Like I think top 5 got two pieces or something like that. And to be honest, like that is already a carrot. Like any unique skin that is only obtained by PvP, that would be. And I mean, even a title would be fine. Like I don't mind. Like, you know, the old titles with the Master of Arena, I can't remember all of them, but they also used to exist back in, like, early time of Guild Wars when you had the queue system with tournament tickets and stuff like that. Doesn't really have to be skins, can be titles, can be finishers, can be even a back, like, I don't know, like, whatever. Like, it's only a limit in your imagination, whatever people enjoy seeing, you know. Something that you can see that this guy has, he's a top player or whatever, or they placed, yeah. Let's see what we... Yeah, I know that they will cry about it. I mean, obviously ArenaNet has to take a decision whether they want to cater like everyone and put everyone in one box, you know, that everyone should be able to obtain everything. But then you're also going to lose the competitive spirit of PvP. Then the only thing that's going to be competitive ever for players is going to be if you ever get into Pro League, if it continues more or less. Like, queuing up the legend will always be the same. It's just a grind, you know, it's just a grind to get rank 80 or... Like, it's nothing behind it. We feared the thief, and then we stealthed him. They don't want to rest him though. Rip. Then we decap. I don't know what they're doing. Like, Necro was super out of position as well. We get the decap though. We can actually fight him. So this is a Retri Rev. I think he's Retri, right? He should be. So we drag him off point. I'm kind of wasting time though doing this, but since my team... Oh, okay, they actually have one more guy. So we interrupt him mid-air, because he was slowed as well, right? He's gonna get the heal, yeah. We stealth. I'm kinda greedy though, and my whole team is wiping. So, yeah, I can't 1v1 this anymore. Almost died, by the way. Yeah, I can't even move anywhere, because, you know, my whole team is dead. So he used Signet already. Here we should kill the druid. I don't know how they are rotating though. Like, they are playing really weird. And our Revis is dying. Thief died, so we rest. But they're dying everywhere anyway, so... We get... Oh no, that was close. We fear here. Oh, he actually got the stomp anyways. And we actually proc the taunt, which is okay. So now we don't have to play careful with the taunt. So we juke a bit, so the warrior believes that we are going close. He might have seen me, he might not have seen me. Thief is gonna spike me. Dodge, and again. They can't really finish anything, it's kind of bad. I feel like I'm getting chased by everything, and Thief is chasing me now. So we gotta be careful. You can probably see him soon. Yeah, you see. So we do this, and then we can actually do this. So they got the stomp, perfect. We stealth the guy. So we get the decap though. Even, like, this decap is more important than the kill, because everyone is on full HP, right? We can do a few takes actually, because we have a kill as well, so. Oh no, my Necro actually died for some reason. Then we kill the druid here. Did we get the druid? No. How did he actually survive? Thief is gonna... No. This is a fucking joke though. And how did they get decapped from behind? And they're way too slow on rotation, so the Guardian is probably gonna die on close before we reach. Now we should be fine. So here we get a peel for... So Necro should die here, because he got... And we go for the rest here. We gotta be careful here, because... We go for decap. He goes for the warrior. I mean, sorry, the Necro is probably gonna die. Like, there are three people. Me being there won't help anything. The Guardian is gonna come there a bit late, but we can actually force a pull cap here. So we are not losing that much momentum, actually. The Thief is probably gonna come for me. It's okay, though. Never mind, it's actually the Necro. And here we help the guard. So... So Thief is gonna try to go for me. It's okay though. So we dodged the... And we get the stomp here. So they're three on close, so we should outnumber this. Dodge the shroud weakness. And then we steal. Interrupt. We fear. I won't get it in time though. I actually got the knockback, so. You stay, you stay, you stay. We can fear him here. We Bassy here. I didn't get the proc. It's okay though, he should just go for the cap here. We Bassy him. So he gets stunned here and I stun him after. So we chain the CC. Don't override it. I really hate the fucking proc from Berserker. Like when you get dealt the killing blow, they get the health spike or whatever. What? How did he make that in time though? Like, I stole him, but I didn't get the steal off. This is also really bad, because if Thief spikes here, he should be dead, right? Yep. And I can't... But we're delaying them, and we actually got the full cap. Ah, I didn't get steel. But we die on point at least, but yeah. But my team lost the whole map. And Ellie's still camping on close. Please, dear God. Has he been sitting on close ever since the fight on close? Oh my God. How are we even in this game? Like, stuff like this just makes me so confused, like, honestly. Like, we're not gonna... They're gonna win now, because our Ellie's still sitting on close. This is not possible. No, I'm gonna die now. Thief is gonna spike me. Yeah, I'm dead. Like, these games are so bad. Like, I honestly really can't get it. No, Ellie. They're not gonna get their cleave off either. They're gonna rally all of them. Alright, we actually got the decap. It actually might not be over if they survive here. If they really, really survive here. Yeah, we might win because of this. No, okay, he's getting decapped now on. Then never mind. Then we can't win. We have to deny the cap too, so it's like kind of awkward. I don't have anything. I'm dead. Yeah, it's over. I can't hold the node against this. Let's hope for one good game at least. Positive mental attitude. When will it get a sub button? I actually have no idea. I don't even know what the requirements are. Around 5-6k followers. I actually have no idea what the requirements are, so I'm not sure. And yeah, like what I meant with dodge necro when they go into shroud, they have like this enfeeble. It's the what's it called? It's the focus 5, I think. No, not focus. It's the I can't remember which. Which weapon set it is. But yeah, it basically puts weakness on you. Dagger 5 maybe. But yeah, it puts weakness on the ground. It's like AoE. So basically you do less damage on the guy. So that's why when you just dodge. Qualify as a Twitch partner, we look for average concurrent viewership of 500 plus. Yeah, it's just I don't stream that often, so that's, I guess. No, yeah, I don't think it's 500. Maybe I should send it. I don't know. Maybe I'll stream a lot more this coming, and then maybe we will see if they. I don't really want to do giveaways, no. Are there any other in-game ways to get earn gems? No, not really. I don't. Some face cam, maybe after California. Yeah, the thing is, like, I would love to stream more, like, but I don't really feel like streaming when after work. Like, I'm super tired. I'm like super tired already, and I wasn't even supposed to stream today, but for some reason I just felt like doing it because after Rom's stream. But if I yeah, I'll see how I mean, it seems like it has gotten easier to get sub buttons for some reason. Yeah, it's the song. What are you doing for a living? I work for the Swedish Chemical Agency, and I work with IT infrastructure.
Did not descend from Adam and Eve.
I don't think this guy is gonna swap, right?
Or any origin story.
Should we go staff then? Oh, never mind, he actually swapped.
My place is the placeless.
Yeah, but when Rom got his sub button, do you remember how much he streamed? He legit streamed for like 6-8 hours a day for fucking 2-3 weeks or something.
I belong to the beloved.
Can you give me advice what to do versus Burst Shadow Mesmer? I mean, it's just bait out their cooldowns. Like when they have bursted once, then you can be offensive. Like, they don't have much left. I mean, I streamed a lot when I had last week of vacation, right? I was online almost fucking every day and streamed for a lot. Yeah, I know that I have to send in an application, of course. We'll see, maybe I'll stream more frequent and then we can give it a shot trying to apply. Like, this is either not like the best opening in the world, but Lions of Persia, it can't go wrong, guys. So he distorted already. They already have one kill in middle. We should go for the... Oh, never mind. We can actually go for this guy, because he... I think he used more cooldowns, actually. I had so many fucking feels, I don't know which one is... whose. We remove the blind with Signet, and then we can actually kill the guy. And then we do stealth, and we decap them from behind. We can actually for- oh, he's gonna get the rest now. Rip. Doesn't matter though. Okay, so one guy is already moving back. Lol. And here we stealth. Okay, never mind. I didn't think I'd get blinded there, but was kind of greedy. I wanted to save the blinding powder for the second stomp from the other guy, and the first one just interrupt with the daze. So they did boss. He's probably... Oh, never mind, I didn't have initiative. But he's probably gonna go middle. Nope. Did the guy leave? Everyone is chasing the poor Mesmer. We're getting decapped on close because everyone is chasing the Mesmer. Like, fucking, what the fuck are you doing? Oh, Jesus. This is what I... Like, these games are not quality games. That much I can say. I can't even port up there. One of them, we trigger Bassi here, so he gets procced. We steal. We got the heal, he's gonna die, and we got second interrupt. He should not be able to rest this. Interrupt, no. And he's dead. I don't see the Mesmer, okay. So we follow the Mesmer. He won't get the decap though. He's gonna shield 5, we dodge. Interrupt. Oh, he distorted that. I can't port up now. It's okay though, he doesn't count my steal anyway, so we get him here. That's trap ranger low. He's probably gonna rally though. I got it, okay. So he rallied. Ooh, I don't have it, fuck. Could have been a sick rally race there though. Too risky to rest there, they have too much We do. We hit him once because he has the passive, right? Oh wow, that random dodge though. Like, why would you ever dodge like that? And this game feels so close, even though it shouldn't be. I don't know what they're doing. Like, they're pinging boss for no reason, like, please. Oh my god, that Condi burst though. Can he stomp? Nope. Okay, so we lost this. Oh my god, the quality of these games are so bad. Look at this guy, he's running from boss to boss. Please don't ever do this in ranked. And this is fucking legendary. Please just don't never do this. And he got stolen as well. Did he not legit see me, or? One is going close. I think, at least. Or what the fuck is he doing? Yeah, I was. So we got the heal. What is the Guardian doing? He's not helping me though. And this is like terrible. I should not even 2v2. He should be dead though. So we get the stomp here. Oh, this is also super fucking terrible. So we have to use the... We got the interrupt, but I don't think... Oh, the mesmer. How are we even winning this game? Like, Jesus Christ. We win with boss anyway, so let's do boss. Oh my god. Hey Taylor. The armor set is the outfit, yes. Do you enjoy the matches? No, right? I don't really do that, no. Do you think TA is coming back one day? No, they're never gonna come back. But yeah, let's try to stream every day now until world tournament or whatever it's gonna call, world championship. And see if we can get Twitch partner because of that. Like if I stream every day, or try at least. I'm getting like the same kind of players again. Yeah, but it's not called WTS, but let's say WTS, then maybe people understand what that means, but yeah. Should we go staff this game? Let's try staff then. One last game with staff. Let's do one more staff then, boys. The thing is, I don't have any. Any way to, like, if I relook. Rune of the Daredevil. Oh, yeah, yeah, that might be true. Fuck it. We go pack runes now. I don't know, I have tons of crit chance, so it should be fine, right? So this means we should team fight. So many guardians though, we can't even do damage. What the fuck was that? Dude, the damage though. What did I even get hit by? My god, I can't even hit the guardians, it's too much F3s everywhere. Ranger pet, yeah, yeah, but that didn't feel like that damage felt way too much for being a fucking ranger pet, to be honest. How am I not hitting anything? I can't even hit them. So bad at staff, by the way. Oops. Nope, couldn't get up. Ranger didn't see us. I want to keep the momentum going. It might be really bad because they have like pretty tanky comp, right? Just kidding, cleave. Nope. Did he just mist form when he was full HP almost? Are you kidding me? I don't know if I'm cleaving, but I think I'm cleaving. We're cleaving, boys! Staff OP, confirmed. Too much blocks. Boom. We on fire, boys. Easy cleave. Oh, wow, I didn't see that he saw me. Well, that was my bad. Don't come for the rest, dude. I feel so dumb playing this build, by the way. Stoneheart, boys. You gotta swap out sometime. Maybe I should have gone like something else on short bow. Ooh, I might die by this actually. I was thinking like easy. He doesn't see me, or? We get the decap for free then. Oh no! Ooh, again, like holy shit, the damage. It's so quick as well. they're not getting the rest in middle either. And then we just go for a decap. Or we can even go for full cap here. Can you explain how to play? Play staff? Not really, like, I don't. This is like the first or second game. I don't even know if we can call the other game. Wow. Didn't work. He doesn't have blink though, so I get the decap for free though. I feel so slow though, like holy shit with bound. I don't even understand how people play bound, honestly. Like, it's so slow. How are they getting the reses, guys? They're not cleaving hard. Again? Are you kidding me? Are we throwing this game? Wow, that blind though. The knock. At least they should be able to clean up on close. Oh, they even got the full cap, so that's okay, I guess. Oh, I didn't see the Guardian. They're still fighting on close, by the way. I've been outnumbering them for like 5 minutes now. I would have killed the Ranger 1v1, but I don't know. I was too busy looking at my dodges. What are they doing? Like, I honestly don't understand. Like, how can you not cleave a down body? Like, it's like you're looking at him and he's like, oh, he's so scary, he's so scary. He fucked up his port with the sword. I don't know if you guys saw it, but... we use the heal here offensively, like... oops. I don't even know what that button does, but okay. I didn't get the stun, right? It's a stun, right? I'm pretty sure it is. Lol, maybe we can win this. Nope. I'm pretty fucked here, am I not? Can I even get out? I'm dying by the fucking... oh, he left me. we're still playing around with him. Nice 1v1, come on. Oh, he has block. We can do it. I'm missing my fucking... No, I'm gonna die now. I think... Nope, he actually stopped chasing me for some reason. Okay, never mind, he sees me. Can't juke anymore. Yeah, I'm playing ranked. Well, we're winning no matter what, so... could Eratemun, yeah, whatever, quote thingy. That's actually the build I wanted to play. Like, if I get a map where I don't, where I'm, like, I kind of need short bow on many maps. Like, let's say this is the build I would probably have ran. Like, maybe it doesn't matter, but let's do this then. So something like this, but not bound, obviously. This is a build I wanted to try out on, like, let's say Forest or Legacy. Then you have the staff cleave with dash, and then you have DP. And Legacy, you kind of don't, like, you can get away with not running shortbow, because it's also a small map, so you don't really need the shortbow to move around that much. Like, it's more crucial maybe on, like, Forest it can work. So I haven't really tried it out, but I kind of want to. Yeah, I know that steel 2 is the combo with staff. Oh. But yeah, but the cleave is kind of terrible with dash and staff only. But if we get Forest or Legacy, I can do it. Yeah, the thing is, I would never drop it for I wouldn't drop it on like Kylo or Temple. It would be way too bad. Do you use Smartcast? I don't know what Smartcast is, so I assume not. The green dot is my mouse cursor, and you can find a link in the FAQ. Like, if you just scroll down, you can, if you want to play with it, you can download it. See a gray cut. What class that is best for a beginner? I don't know, like it depends on what you prefer, what you want to play yourself, but I mean warrior is pretty okay I guess to start with, or guardian. No, you were like, wasn't it you were talking in Lion's Arch the other day about offending or whatever, I can't remember, something like that. Yeah, best class for beginners, either Guardian or Warrior. I just really dislike Bound, it's so easy to get killed. Do you have an Azura Thief? No, I don't. I have a Char Thief. But yeah, I really dislike Bound. It makes you take so much unnecessary damage. You see, like, even the Druid can just run after you and... Oh yeah, maybe I should change... But yeah, even the Druid can just chase you after, like, and spam one, and you just eat all the damage because you can't, even do anything about it, you know. I used to have Azuras, but I deleted them all. At least the thieves. Maybe we can do a Char Thief game. Play sword, pistol, staff on Char. I don't really play roaming, so it's kind of hard for me to give you a good opinion on that. But I'd say, like, sword X in PvP is kind of trash because it's just bad. But in World vs. World, it's way different since you have a lot more damage. Like, it's crazy how much damage you have. Yeah, I know, it's a knockdown. Like, it's a 2 second stun, or whatever. You remember Skooz? I used to lose a lot of duels back in the days because I only played SD back then. But once I started main DP, I'd never really dueled. When I started PvPing, I was only playing SD. Cleave on short boy is a joke compared to staff. Yeah, 100%. The only thing I dislike is that you don't really have any access to poison. I don't even remember him, so not really. Let's go, boys, with the Char. How can you not like mature. I'm gonna tilt because I hate Char, because the animation is so big and you can't really see what you're doing sometimes. Oh no, is this the... No, it's not the guy. Isn't this like some fucking pre-made? I think they are pre-made. I'm pretty sure they are, right? Let's see. Yep, APU. I think there are two or three, man. Alright, good night, guys. Oh, he wants to go far. Thief already spiked him. He's gonna swap to sword soon and port out, yeah. We get him still. I love the stomp animation though. Nice finisher. So we're probably gonna have one going close. I don't know what this guy is doing though. Like, he's just wasting time. It's a full cap node he's fighting on, right? So it's really bad, actually. But they should get close. I mean, this is okay though. Oh, I didn't get the port. RIP. Perfect time to spike as well, because he... Ah, oh, he got the clone just in second. We just sealed up extra. Oh, I didn't get the last one. They can't interrupt my stomp here though. So we get stomp, we go close to plus one. I assume they have the thief on respawn. No, he's actually on far. They're close. So thief, we go for thief here. It should be an easy kill, which is. We keep cleaving him, because if he starts resting here, he might even get the rest, but no, too late. So here we can juke. We can, maybe if the rev actually starts to disengage. Yeah, then we get the decap. Thief might... No, he doesn't see me. RIP. He missed his steal. Wow, he runs some weird shit. Blind him so he can steal. He missed the steal again. We kill him. Easy kill. Then we try to... We juke him back so he thinks I'm gonna decap. Then we stealth up fully. So he just sits on node now. And we interrupt warrior and we rest. And we share Bassie. Oh wow, he actually changed to me. Here we are a bit late to close. Even though, like, on, in theory, if the rev is invo, he should actually beat. Yeah, that's what I meant. We spin here because he probably has the daggers, and then we reflect them. You see, easy. We interrupt him. He's gonna die. Then here we get the rest because we stealth him. No, he either he revealed himself or yeah, that was bad. Oh well, that's okay. How did he get the knock there? Weird. So Thief is outnumbering Druid. Druid used Signet. We can steal plus one. Because it's the Thief. If the Druid gets stealth here and resustains, we give him... Because Thief already used Steel, so we can be offensive now on the Mesmer, right? We can stealth him here. And then we spike the Mesmer. The slow is fucking me over though, hard. Interrupt him. We lassie here. Oh, I didn't make it in time. We got him still. We rest. He might headbutt me, but it's okay. So Thief is trying to 1v1 in middle. I don't have enough cleave for this, I think. Nope. You see how ridiculous this is. So Thief is chasing me, but close is open, so I'll get close for free. They should not overcommit here. They're probably gonna all wipe them far, except our guardian is fine in the middle. So Thief's trying to 1v1 me. He's gonna sword 2. No, never mind. He tried to use the... Oh, fuck. I'm still revealed? That was weird. You could see that he wanted to use the, what's it called? The F2 from Thief. We got the stun though. Oh wow, that block. Why would you start blocking that far away? Like dude, no one is even hitting you. Maybe he's just a god. He knows that I'm gonna steal him. Like, the whole idea was to steal him before he starts blocking. Oh, never mind. Now I might actually die. Yep. Nah, never mind. I got the scrapper, boys. Easy res. We clear this, because otherwise I'm going to be under pressure. It's a kind of a bad fight. What? He doesn't have any stun break, so he's dead. We gotta cleave hard though. Or maybe the scrapper even. Nah, we should go for the mess here. I didn't get interrupted. So I'm gonna stomp this guy. And then we actually move to middle. Thief is probably gonna come here again. Or go middle, so that's why I kind of want to go to middle. They should be fine in on close. It's also super tanky, so yeah, he comes here. So we plus one the this guy. And we kill the Thief. And then we kill Rev. And then we decap 4. Shard Thief OP. Why do you spam unseethed weapon and seethed? It's just a habit. When you 1v1 thieves and you auto attack like this, they can headshot you and they interrupt you, right? So you take pulmonary procs for no reason. If you stall the weapon every time, you won't. So it's more like a habit, but also, if you are like auto attack spamming, it's like sometimes you can't headshot if you get stuck in a chain of auto attacks. It takes too long, you know, you have to wait until the auto attack is finished. But if you stole the weapons, you can headshot. No, it's Doom procs are only single target. That's why it's like dagger cleave, you apply poison, and short bow, you can apply poison and then cluster. But as you said, like short bow cleave is completely fucking garbage. But yeah, like dagger cleave is obviously the best, but you take so much counter cleave, and yeah, retaliation is ridiculous. And Vault obviously gives you evade frames, so you don't take as much clear, but CC obviously will still fuck you, so... I mean, yeah. Also, the cast is kinda long on Vault, so blocks and stuff can just save it easily. Meanwhile, auto-attacks on Dagger are much quicker. So yeah, that's why I still prefer Dagger Cleave over Staff, but if I had to pick between Shortbow and Staff, I would probably pick Staff every single time, because there's so much projectile things as well, like Ellie, Guardians, Mesmers, Scrap, like everything has more or less like some kind of feel that you can't. But yeah, I think that was my last game. Like I'm already way up, like up way too late because I got work tomorrow. I usually sleep by now, so yeah, I don't think I'm gonna host anyone. But yeah, thanks for tuning in, guys. I wasn't even supposed to stream, I just wanted to, like, I moved last Monday, so I have new internet that is not as good, so I didn't know if it's gonna be bad or good, but it seems fine, actually. It's not terrible. So yeah, I'll probably stream tomorrow if I'm not too tired, which I probably will be, but yeah, we'll see. But yeah, guys, good night, and thanks for hanging out, and yeah, I hope you guys enjoy.